Welcome to my channel Learn More. In this video I am going to explain you complete MS Office course. So for that, first of all, let us open Office. You can directly go here. I had placed my Office in my taskbar, or you can directly search here using it MS Office, or you can go to the Windows Start button and open it. So let's open it. So this is the main page of the MS Office, as you can see here. In general, in daily life, we know that office means having the technical or non-technical, and having the benches and the files and like the different type of objects or different type of things placed in a single building is known as office, as we know that. So in this office means, Microsoft Office means having the different type of applications in a single application is called a Microsoft Office. Like you can see here, there are different type of applications, and we have more applications too. Like as you can see here, there are different type of applications placed in a single applications which we use Microsoft Office. This is called as Microsoft Office. So in this office we can see here Access, Calendar, Excel, Flow, Outlook, OneNote, like that. You can see here there are different type of applications, and you can have more like this too, and you can learn tips and tricks from this, and you can use Bing, MSN, privacy and rewards from this. So in this tutorial you are going to learn about the Excel, OneNote, PowerPoint and Word. Why? Because I'm not saying that you already know this. Like Calendar means normally you use in your daily life. OneDrive means it is like a drive which you can store access like this. You can meet people and you can create forms. You can create forms in this Excel too. So I have selected the Excel. So in our daily life, Excel is basic. So I am telling about this Excel. And coming to the Outlook, this is about your like a Gmail which you use in your daily life, and Skype means to make the video calls, and to do you can also do in your OneNote. And coming to the Sway, you can create anything which you can do in the Word too, like that. So Excel and OneNote, PowerPoint and Word are the basics, so I am explaining this. And coming to the last, I am going to explain you one more also, WordPad, which is a basic in your systems, that means in your Windows 10. So let us start our course. So first of all, let's close this, and first of all I am going to explain you MS Excel. So let's search it, MS Excel. MS is nothing but Microsoft. So let's open it, this Microsoft Excel. Okay, in background we can see here it is opening. It take a little bit time. First of all, I am going to give you a brief introduction about this Excel, and I am going to explain you each and every option in this Excel. So this is the main page of this Excel, as you can see here. I am selecting the blank workbook. Why? Because in this blank workbook only I can explain you each and every option clearly. And these are different type of templates, as you can see here. And you can click here in the more templates option, and you can go here. And you can see there are different type of templates here. You can use any of these, but if I use any of this, I can't access to every option. There are certain limits, so I am selecting the blank workbook. So let's select this blank workbook. In our daily life, you can see Excel is used for the billings or for the major calculation purposes, or in the schools for attendance purposes. Like this, Excel is used in many ways. So first of all, let's start with the introduction, and then I'm going to explain you about the each and every menu. I will explain you about the file, home, insert, page layout, formulas, data, like that. I am going to explain you each and every menu. In that menu there are different types of options. I am going to explain each of this. Why? Because as we know clearly about the each option only, we can use it. So I am going to explain you this. So first of all, let's come to the introduction. As you can see here, there are different type of boxes. These are called as cells. And coming to these cells, as you can see here, A1 is written here. You can see here, I have highlighted. A1 is nothing but A is the row and 1 is the column. How can I say that means? Moving towards the downwards. That means you can see here. Moving towards the downwards like this. And moving towards the upwards by using the upward arrow and downward arrow, you can move these cells. We moving towards the downwards is called the row, and moving towards the sidewards, towards the left or towards the right, you can use the sideward buttons to move this. To moving towards the sidewards is called the column. As you can see here, as I move the to the another cell, here the name changes. You can see here C1. C means row, and you have been in this row, right? This is the row and this is the column. As I have there in the A1 cell, you can see here it is not highlighted. So this is the A1, and if I click here in the B1 cell, it is in the B rows and first column. Hope you guys understood about this. In which cell are you there? It is the cell name. You can see here. It is the cell name. You can change the cell name to like C5. If you enter like this, the cell name changes. You can observe, right? Like this, you can change the cells. These are called the cells, and this is the cell name. And coming to here, you can see sheet 1. This is the Excel sheet 1 or worksheet 1. You can name anything. This is called the sheet 1. If you want to add more number of sheets, you can click this plus button, which is circle, and you can add a new sheet. And coming to here, you can slide like this. In our Excel, there are the n number of cells, and n number of cells, how can you say that means? Moving towards the columns. See, as you move on, the cells changes. As you can notice here, the characters here, names, cells changes. You can observe here, as we move on, the cells increases towards the column. As we move on towards the row, the cell number changes. As you move, as you can notice in the left side of the screen, you can see the number increases. As we move on, the cells increases like that. You can access here, like moving here, you can see here, you can scroll the cells by using this. You can scroll here, or directly you can enter the name here like this. A1, it comes to the first cell like this. In which cell you want, you can search here. And coming to here, this is zooming option. To zoom the cells, use this option. And for breaking the page or to fit the page, use these three options. If you want the grids like this, you use this option. This is the basic introduction about this Excel sheet. And as you know, this is the save option, and undo and redo options are placed here by using arrow symbols. And coming to here, this is your account, which you have. My account name is Akash Riddler, so I had it is showing that my name, and based upon the name which you had given, your name will be displayed here, and this is your account. And if you want to if you want ribbon display, you can use this ribbon display option. And coming to here, minus button, this is minimize, and this is maximize, and this is close button. If you want to share to any device, you can use this share option. This is the basic introduction which everyone wants to learn in this Excel. And coming to the menus, first one is file. I'm going to explain you right now about this. Let's select this file. In this file, you can see different type of option. Home means nothing but home menu. As I in the first I have told you, this there are different type of templates here. By clicking the more templates, you can see different type of templates. And recent means nothing but if you have done any project here, or you can see here different type of projects in the recent button. And coming to the new, if you want to do any new project, or if you want to do any new thing, new worksheet or new or anything new project, you can select this new one and you can click that. As you can see here, this is also available in the home page. Same home page is nothing but the new page. Why? Because if you want to do anything new, you have to go to the new, or you can directly access from the home page. And coming to the open, if you want to open any projects which you have done any previously, or if you want to open from your PC, or if any projects are there in your OneDrive, you can open from it. Or if you want to browse it, you can browse it and bring this to the Excel sheet. And coming to the info, this is about the information about your project. There are different type of properties here. It will show the properties and account related things. That means the information about the project which you are doing. And coming to the save, if you want to save the project, you can use this save option. And coming to the save as option, if you have done any changes in your project, and if you want to save that project, you can save use this save as option. And coming to the print, if you want to print your Excel sheet, you can use this print option. If you want to share, like means to the online services, or if you want to share to the people, or to the mails, or if you want to share to the mail, or if you want to save to the cloud, you can use this save option. Coming to the export, if you want to export this Excel sheet to different type of files, that means PDFs or XPS, or to change the file type, you can use this export option. And coming to the publish, if you want to publish to any online services, you can use this publish option. And coming to the close, if you want to close this Excel, you can use it, or you can use this you can see here close button at the top of right side top, you can see here, you can use this close option. And coming to the account, this is your account related details, you can see here too. And coming to the feedback, if you want to give the feedback, you can give here too. And coming to the options, there are different type of options. You can see here, as these options are available here too, so I am not explaining about this each and every option. These options are available here too, so I am not explaining about this. So this is about the file. And coming to the home, coming to the first, let us do a small project so you can understand and you can use each and every option. Coming to the small project I am doing, so I am taking the student mark list. So for that we need first one name, and coming to the second cell, subject 1, subject 2, name A, B. Let's take the name as A and B. And coming to the subject 1, he got 5 marks for A, and in subject 1 for B, he got around 9 marks. And in subject 2, let's think he failed. And in subject 2, A get pass marks like 8. And coming to the total, we can do manually this 500, and the total is 13. We can do manually like this, but I am not doing that. Why? Because I will show you how to do automatically this sum. Why? Because as this is the small calculation, we can do manually. If there are large number of calculation, oh, we can't do that. So we have to do auto sum. I will explain you later about this. In this home menu only you can get this option, auto sum. I will tell you at the time how to use that auto sum. So let's coming to the first option, cut copy paste, how to use that. So if you want the subject one to cut here and to place in the another cell, you use this cut option. Like means you can see here, you can cut this subject one, and you, if you want to place here, you can use this paste option. So in the you can notice here, subject one has been cutted here and it has been placed here. Like this we can use cut and paste option. Copy means nothing but if you want to copy the subject one, and if you want to place here, like means if you want to copy the subject one, like you can use copy option. If you want to place here, you can use paste option. Like this, it will be placed. For the shortcuts, you can use this. For cut, you can use Ctrl X. For copy, you can use Ctrl C. For paste, you can use Ctrl V. Why I am telling shortcuts means, if you it will save our time. If you want to cut this subject one and if you want to paste here like this, you can use Ctrl X. And if you want to place here, you can use Ctrl V shortcut. It saves our time and you can so you will be professional by doing that. So if anyone sees you that moving here to the copy and you are doing again paste means they will know that you are not professional and you didn't learn the codes very properly. So by using the shortcuts you can learn easily and you can access easily this Excel. So better learn shortcuts. And coming to the next options, font means nothing but if you want to change the font style of or the font size or the font color, likewise you can use this font option. I will explain you. There are different type of fonts here. I will show you how to change it. I have selected the name. If I want to change the font of it, you can notice here, you can notice the name fonts changing. See, as you can notice the font of the name changes. If you want to change the font size, you can change the font size either by selecting this or you can directly give a number like this. Like this you can give a number like 45. If you have given and given the enter, so like this you can change the font size and resizing it. If you want to increase the font size a little bit, you can use it. If you want to decrease the font size to a little bit, you can use this. If you want to font size to be bold or italic to underline, you can use this option. For bold you can use Ctrl plus B. For I you can use Ctrl plus I. For underline you can use Ctrl plus U. Like this you can use the bold option, italic option and underline option. If you want to add the borders to the fonts at the bottom or to the top, likewise you can use this border option. If you want to change the color of the cell, you can use this option. As you can notice, color of the cell changes. There are different type of colors. You can use any of these and you can change it. If you want to change the font color, likewise if you want to change the font color, there are different type of colors. You can use any of these colors. Likewise you can change this font color. And coming to the alignment is nothing but, as you can see here, name is towards the left side of the cell. If you want to bring it to the center or to the top or to the right side of the cell, so if you want to change the alignment of that character, you can use it. As you can see here, alignment changes to the top. Likewise you can use it to change the alignment of the cells. You can use this alignment option. And next, coming to the wrap text. Wrap text is nothing but if you have texted anything bigger characters or bigger words, it exits the cells. If you want this to be placed in a particular cell only, as you can see here, it exits to the F and it exits to the G also. If you want to place this total word in a single cell, then you can use this wrap text. As you can see here, it is placed in the text only. In this cell only, so you can use this wrap text or wrap text option like this. And coming to the merge and center, as you can notice, in between the cells there are lines. If you don't want these lines, so I am selecting these three cells. In between these three cells you can have these three lines. If you don't want these lines in between the cells, you can use this merge and center option. You can notice lines has been erased. like this you can use this merge and center option. That means if you want to merge these three cells, you can use this option. Likewise, merge and center option is useful. And coming to the numbers, I'm arranging it as the cell size is bigger. I'm arranging it, and coming to the numbers, let's select the number. And if you want to increase the decimal size or decrease the decimal size, likewise you can increase the decimal size and you can decrease the decimal size. There are different type of options here too. If you want to increase, likewise you can use the currencies or date and times. Likewise, if you want to increase any decimal size or percentages, I can see. If you want to use any of this option based upon the number, so you can use this option. And coming to the styles, there are, you can see there are four colors, not only four colors. You, by clicking this downward arrow, you can see there are different type of colors here. You can use any of these. So I will tell you how to use that. As you can see, normally is highlighted, that means we are using the white color. If you want to use this good, you can use it. As 9 is a good mark, you can use this good. And 8 is neutral, you can click on the neutral. And 2 is bad, that means a failure, you can use this. And 5 is normal, you can access to the normal. Likewise, you can use it. And coming to the insert or delete cells, if you want to insert a cell in between 8 and 2, likewise you can insert it. And if you want to delete it, you can delete it too. And coming to the editing, as I have told you at the first, I am not doing the total. Why? Because I am selecting these two and automatically this Excel sheet only generates the total. How means? Just click on the auto sum. You can see here 13 has been displayed. Once again, I am showing you, just observe it. I am doing the auto sum for this 9 and 2. Likewise, it will give us the total. Likewise you can use this auto sum. And coming to the fill, if you want to fill this 9 to 11 to the upper cells too, that means in place of 5 you should 9 should be displayed, and in place of 8 should be 2 should be displayed, in place of 13 11 should be displayed. Likewise, if you want to fill it, you can use this fill option. And coming to the clear, if you want to clear anything, you can use this clear option. And coming to the sort and filter, if you want to sort bigger number to smaller number, or small number to bigger number, or if you want to the smallest to the largest. Likewise, if you want to sort anything or if you want to filter anything, you can use this sort and filter option. And coming to the find and select option, you can see there are different type of options. I will explain you one. In likewise only you can use any of these. And I will explain you replace. Replace is nothing but if you select the replace, there are two different options. So I have selected this. What should be replaced? Find what? What should be find here? Let's search A and find next. So you can see here A is there in total. So this cell has been highlighted. And coming to the next, so A is there in the eighth row second column. So you can see here, so A has been highlighted. So likewise, if you want to replace this A with another word like C or any of your wish, so you can use this option and you can select the replace. Replace option, you can notice here in the place of A, C has been changed. Likewise, you can change it. Likewise, you can change it. So I can write in this to the A. So this is about the find and select option, and this is about the home page. Hope you learned about it. And coming to the insert, If you want to insert any tables or pictures or any shapes or any graphs or any parlance, likewise if you want to insert any symbols, you can use insert option. Insert means to insert in a particular cell or to insert in this Excel sheet. So if you want to add any table, likewise you have to select the table and you have to give the data for the table likewise, and you can insert it by clicking OK. So this is how we can create a table. And if you want to add illustrations like pictures or shapes or smart art, or if you want to take the screenshots, you can use this. So I will explain you about the shapes. Likewise only you can add pictures. You can add pictures from your device or from the online pictures too. So I'm coming to the shapes. I'm adding the shapes. Likewise only you can add these four options. Why I am not explaining each and every option right now from this, because you have to do practice. If I explained everything about this, you will not practice. Okay, he explained, so we don't need to practice, you think. So I'm requesting you to practice everything so that you can learn this Excel very well. So if you want to know about each and every option, that means I didn't explain about this picture clearly or the smart art clearly, right? And this pivot table and recommended pivot table, right? Because so you have to place this cursor right the option which you want. That means you have to place the option right here, recommend pivot table. So they will display a dialog box. Read that content so that you can understand each and everything which you are going to do, so that you can learn easily. So if you want to learn about this pivot table, place your cursor there, a dialog box appears. If you want to learn more about this, and you can see here, tell me more. So likewise you can use likewise you can learn this option. And coming to the shapes, if you want to insert the shapes, if you want to insert this shape here, right here, you can insert like this. So likewise you can insert it. As you can notice in the menu, a format menu has opened. When I have inserted these shapes, a format menu has opened. That means to insert any shapes, that means to insert more shapes or to edit the shape or to text box or to change the colors of these. So like is, if you want to change the colors of this, or if you want to shape fill, you can use any of these colors. Or if you want to change the font styles, if you want to change the font style, you can use it. And coming to the arrange, bring forwards and backward. For this option, we need another picture too. Why? Because if you want to add this triangle, if you want to add this triangle like this, as triangle is forwarded, triangle is forward, then the backward picture. So I am changing the color so that you can notice well. So as it is forward, so if you want to bring send to that backward, you can use like this option. Hope you guys understood about this forward and backward option. So once again, observe it, as triangle is backward of this first shape which I have taken. So use this bring forward option to bring the triangle forward, or if you want to send the triangle backward, you can use this send backward option. Likewise you can use it. So if you want to change the shape or change the sizes, you can use it. If you want to change the size, likewise you can change it. Likewise you can use this format option. And coming to the insert, if you are having any ad accounts, you can see here, get ads, Bing maps. If you are having any ad accounts, you can add these accounts to the cell which you want. And coming to the charts, there are different type of charts, as you can notice here. There are different type of charts. If you want to add any of these charts, you can use this charts option. And coming to the tours, if you want to add any 3D maps to your Excel sheet, you can use this 3D map option. And coming to the Sparkline is nothing but, as you can see here, use line option, column option, and win or lose option. So if you want to add any of this, same as the charts only, if you want to add any of this, you can see here. And coming to the filters, as filters are mentioned in the home too. So you can see here, filters, So if you want to add any filters, you can use this option, or you can directly go to the insert option and you can use these filters. Or next, coming to the links, if you have any link in a links, that means if you have any personal blog or any website or any channels, not only like this, you can access any of the links from the internet and you can place in the cell which you want. So likewise, link option is used. And coming to the text, if you want to add any headers or footers, or if you want to add any word art like this, if you want to add to any word art, so I'm adding my channel name like this. If you want to add any word art, so if you want to resize it, so likewise you can add this word art option. And coming to the symbols, there are different type of symbols. As you can see here, you can add any type of symbol. So likewise you can insert it. Insert, you can notice here a symbol has been added. If you want to add any equations, sorry, you have to close it before doing any operation. If you want to add any equations, so there are different type of equations. You can see here a design format has been opened, so you can access any type of equations or any type of structures. There are n number of structures here. You can use any of these like this. You can see here I am explaining you a single option, so likewise only you can add it. So you can see here, let's give a number 5 to the power 2. So likewise you can use this for formula or equation option. So this is about the insert. So I am not explaining you each and every option. Why? Because you have to practice of your own, as I had given you the tip. So if you want to learn about this chart, period chart, you can go there and place your cursor there and a dialog box appears and you can read it and you can learn about it. And coming to the page layout, if you want to change the page size, or if you want to add the borders, or if you want to remove these grid lines or headings, you can use this page layout. So first of all, coming to the themes, there are different type of themes here. You can see you can use any type of a theme here for your project which you are doing. As you can see here, based upon the theme, our letters changes. As you can see, so I am keeping in office mode only. If you want to change the colors too, you can change the colors. If you want to change the fonts, you can change the fonts. If you want to add any effects like this, there are different type of effects, you can add any of this. And coming to the page setup, if you want to set up your page, like means I have told you, if you want to add any margins or orientation, or if you want to resize it, or if you want to break the page, I will explain you about this break the page. This is something a little bit newer to you. So if you want to break the page in between F and G, you can use this break option. Break option like this. How to show it means, I will explain you how to show this page break later. Why? Because it as we are seeing the grid options, we can't notice the page break. I will show you. And coming to the scale to fit, if you want to fit your page, like means it has been automatic. If you want to give that to 1 page or 2 page or 3 page or 9 pages, like the number of pages here, more pages, you can click this more page option to add the number. So I am telling you that it's better to keep in the automatic. As you are learning the basics, you can keep it in the automatic. And coming to the scale, if you want to change the scale, you can use this option. And coming to the grid lines, I am offing these grid lines. Now you can see this space break in between J and K. You can see the space break. Hope you guys see the space break. So likewise, you can use the space break option if you want the grid line. And coming to the headings, if you don't want the headings, you can use this option. So coming to the headings, I have already explained you when I have inserted the picture, backward and forward selection plane. If you want to align towards the alignment is nothing but you can see in the home page too. Alignment, so same, that alignment and this alignment is a little bit similar only. And coming to the formulas, as I have explained you the equations in the insert page, equations in the insert page, same likewise only formula option is used. to insert any formula. We use this formula option to insert any function or to order some, as I have explained at the time of the total. So likewise, you can use it. If you want to learn about more about that, you can place your cursor there. As I have told you, a dialog box appears there and you read it and you learn. You should learn about yourself so that you can learn easily and you can understand which option is used for what purpose. So I'm telling you that read for every option. So if I have missed any option or missed any point regarding that, you can note that. So likewise, each and every option is useful. And coming to the data, if you want to add any data from your PCs or from your web or from your drive or from anything, if you want to add any data regarding that, you can use this data option. You can notice here sort and filter option. You can notice in the home page too, sort and filter options. And coming to the review, if you want to review, that means if you want to translate or if you want to add any spellings or if you want to add any comments or if you want to translate your page or if you want to translate the language, you can use this translate option. For the spellings, you can use this option. For the accessibility, you can use it. If you want to add any comment to the cell, like means this cell, you can go to this new comment and add it. So welcome. Likewise, you can add it. And if you want to delete it, you can delete it. So you can notice the red color here deleted. Once again, I will show you. So the cell which contains the comment will be highlighted like this, in red color will be highlighted like this. So if you add a comment like anything, learning Excel, and likewise this has been highlighted here. If you want to delete it, you can delete it. Likewise, you can use this comment option. If you want to protect your sheet, you can use this protect option. If you want to hide the links, you can use this. If you have inserted any link using your website, if you want to hide it, you can use this hide link option. And coming to the view, that means if you want to view normal view or page break view, like that, if you want any type of view, or if you want the grid lines or formula bar or headings. Likewise, if you don't want anything, that means view is nothing but how should your page look, how should your Excel sheet look. That is the main reason to use this view, how and what the view should be there. So likewise, if you want to change the view of your worksheet, you can use this view option. If you want to zoom it, you can use this zoom option. Or if you want to fit to the 100%, you can fit to this. If you want to zoom the selected area, you can use this select area option. If you want to add new windows or arrange or any such type of window related things, you can use it. And likewise, this view option is useful. And coming to the help, if you want to call to anyway, if you want to call, contact this Excel members, or if you want to get any trainings, you can use this option. Or if you have any problem in your Excel sheet, you can contact them. And coming to the tell me what do you want, if you want to search here, like means as you are a beginner or an intermediate, so you don't know which option is placed where. So if you want to search, like means if you want shortcut, if you want to search about the font, font options has been displayed, you can use this option directly from here, as you don't know which option is placed where as you are a beginner. At the first it will be new. After using, you can know which option is placed where and how to use that option. Likewise, you can use this option. Hope you guys learned about each and every option and each and every menu in this. So this is about the Excel sheet. option. So you can use and you can improve your skills by doing different type of a project. So I'm requesting you to follow my tip. Likewise, if you don't know about this merchant center option or if you don't understand what I have explained, so place your cursor there properly and you can see a dialog box there and learn from that. So this is my tip, so which I'm going to give you. So this is about the Excel sheet. Hope you learned about this two various projects, three or four projects, so that you can learn what is what, so you can get you can be a professional or you can be advanced in this Excel. So likewise, Excel is used. And coming to the next one, PowerPoint. Let's open it. In this PowerPoint also, you can see the similar options as the Excel. In Excel, we had seen the first in the whole file menu, we had seen like this. In that PowerPoint 2, you can notice here I am taking the blank presentation, and you can notice in the file same options are displayed. Why? Because in Microsoft applications like MS Office or MS Excel, that means similar to PowerPoint, and coming to the Word, it is also similar. We can notice the similar option. Let's go to the Office. I will show you. Let's go to the Office. As I told you, I will explain you about the Excel, PowerPoint, OneNote, and coming to the Word. You can see similar options. I will open you each and everything. I will explain you in the Word too. Let's open this Word. See, you can see same option in the Word too. Yes, the design is same, not the option. We shouldn't call that option. So design is same. You can see here, so same options will be also same. So you can notice here there are the same file, home, insert, design, page layout, references, view, help. Same each and every option in Excel is placed in each and every option in the PowerPoint. You can notice when I go to the blank presentation, same options. So wait a moment. So each and our, see, you can use, see this home option. So same options in the Excel are there. So, but a little bit change. In this PowerPoint, you do projects in slide. In Excel, you do projects in cells. In Word, you will do in a blank sheet. So likewise, same options are displayed. So I am telling you that, so you learn of your own. As I have explained you the Excel very clearly, each and every option, so you learn of your own. Why? Because if you learn of your own only, so I have learned of my own, like each and every option I have gone to each and every option. I had read about the option and learned about it. So I am requesting you to also learn of your own. Why? Because if you learn of your own, you will know which option is useful for what purpose. Likewise, you can learn it. So I am requesting you to learn each and every option of yourself. Why? Because I had given you the tip too. So if you want to know about this AI, you don't know about this AI placed option here, so you can place your cursor there and a dialog box appears about it and read about it, so that you can learn easily about that option. Likewise, you can learn it. So in further, I am going to do separate videos, tutorials about this Word and PowerPoint too, so you can access from that. If you don't understand or if you have felt any difficulty about this Word or PowerPoint presentation, you can see the further videos which I am going to do in the further days. You can see that. So this is about the PowerPoint. So Excel means nothing but we do in the form of cells. PowerPoint is nothing but we do in the form of slides. word is nothing but we do in the form of a sheet. That means an empty sheet. There are no like this, you can sheet. So coming to the note. Sorry, this note is different from that note. And coming to the one note. One note for Windows 10. You can see here a dialog box appears, so close it. They will give the tips. If you want to learn it, you can use it. So this is the sheet. This is the OneNote sheet. So OneNote is nothing but if you want to note anything or if you want to write anything here, you can write it in the home. There are simple option, home, insert, draw and view option. There are simple options. This is the home menu which you are going to see. If you want to add any letters or if you want to add any thing like this, if you want to cut it or copy it or paste it to use simply, this is the OneNote for the Windows 10. So Microsoft had designed they designed this word in a simple manner. So the options which you see in this word is nothing but each and everything is specified clearly. But if you know how to use this word, you can use this OneNote too. So that's why I'm explaining you or telling you in the last. So this is about the OneNote. I'm going to write each and everything here. So insert, coming to the insert option, if you want to insert any tables or if you want to insert any files or if you want to print outs or if you want to add any pictures or links, symbols, equations like this, you can add. So I am explaining you one example. Likewise only you can add anything. I am adding the equation. So these are equation tool. If you want to add any type of equations like this, so if you want to add anything equation, as you can see here, if you want to add anything like 5, so 5 on the upper scale, you can see the dot. So if you want to add any equation, likewise you can add anything like this. This is very simple to use. OneNote is very simple to use. So they have designed in a simple manner, so everyone can access. And coming to the draw, if you want to draw anything, so if you want to draw anything like this, or if you want to add the shapes, or if you want to add any ink to the shapes, you can add this. So you can draw like this. So like this draw option is used. And coming to the view, as you learned in the Excel and PowerPoint and Word to Word, view is nothing but how should your view of this window should be. Likewise, how should the view of the window should be. Likewise, this option is used. View option is used. If you want to delete the notes, you can delete it. Likewise, you can delete it. If you want to add the rule, you can use this rule option. If you want to like this, you can use it. If you likewise, you can use this option, view option. And coming to the help, if you want to contact them or feedback them, or if you want to do any trainings, you can use this option. And coming to this, this is the page synchronization option. This is about the tips and tricks which they will give you. As I have told you the tips and tricks, no need to access this. Or if you want to see once again about this, you can access that. And coming to the share, if you want to share anything, or if you want to share to the another PC or to the share to the mail, you can use this option. This is the page extension full screen mode. And these are the option settings and the more. You can have different type of settings or you can print it. And this is your account, and this is minimize, maximize and close buttons. And this is undo and redo options, and this is the home button. So this is about the OneNote for the Windows 10. I have already explained in my channel, and you can go to that and you can learn about this. I will give the link in the description too, and you can click that link and you can learn about this OneNote very clearly. So this is about OneNote, and I have told you, and in the last I am going to explain you WordPad. Let's open it. So this is the WordPad. WordPad is similar to the word, as you can see here. I will explain you about this word clearly, WordPad clearly, so you can notice both are similar. So about this word clearly, WordPad clearly, so that you can learn. In file you have different options like new, open, save, save as. You know about this new. New is nothing but to do any new project. You can select this new option. If you want to open any project you have done previously, you can use this open option. If you want to save it, you can use this. You can use Control S to save this option as a shortcut. Save as also you can use the Control S. And coming to the print, if you want to print anything, you can use this print option. And coming to the page break, page setup, if you want to set your page, you can use it. If you want to send the work which you have done in the mail, you can use the send in mail option. About WordPad, if you want to learn about the WordPad, you can use it. And if you want to exit it, you can use this exit option. And coming to the up, you can see here, this is the save, undo, redo, and this is the option which you can customize your access. And this is the minimize, maximize, and close options. If you want to add any help from them, if you want any help, you can use this question mark symbol with circle. You can use this help option. And coming to the home, let's type anything here. Let's I am learning. Learning WordPad. Likewise, if you want to learn about this, as you are learning the WordPad, I am selecting this to show each and every option only. For that purpose only, I had the texture like this. You can use any of the text or the characters, or if you want to add any of the names, you can add not only like this, you can add any of the things which you want. So I am selecting this. You can use the shift button to select, or to select everything you can control, use Control A. Likewise, you can select it. If you want to cut this, or if you want to place right here, you can use this Control V. Control V is the shortcut for the paste. You can use this option. So if you want to copy this, Control C copy this, or if you want to paste here, you can paste here. Likewise, you can use this cut copy paste option. And coming to the font, if you want to change the font styles, or if you so there are different type of font styles, if you want to change it font styles, or if you want to change the font size, or if you want to increase a little bit, or if you want to decrease a little bit font size, you can use this option. So if you want these words to be to in the bold, or to in the italic, or to the underline, you can use this options. Or if you want to strike that, you can use this strike option. If you want this to be suffix or a prefix, you can use these options. And coming to the colors, if you want to change the colors, you can use any of this option. Likewise, I'm increasing to show you. You want to change it, you can use it. If you want to give the underlines for the if you want to give the colors to the background, you can use this option. And coming to the paragraph, this is nothing but the alignment option which I have shown you in the Excel. So if you want it to be centered, you can use it. If you want to be light sided, or if you want to like this alignment, in which alignment you want, you can select it. And this is about the paragraph. And coming to the insert, to insert anything, to likewise to insert the pictures, or if you want to draw it, or if you want to add date and time. So example, I'm showing you, if you want today is the 9th June 2020, if I want this 9th June 2020, I can insert it like this. You can insert it. If you want to add any object, you can use insert it. Or if you want to find anything in this or replace anything in this, you can use this editing option. Likewise, home is used. And coming to the view, to view, to zoom in, or to zoom out, or to fit to the 100%, or if you don't want the ruler, as you can see at the top, ruler is displayed. If you don't want it, you can set. If you want the status bar, as you can see in the down, status bar is nothing but if you want to zoom it, you can use this status bar option. I'm fitting to the page. So likewise, you can use this show and hide option. Coming to the settings, if you want word wrap, or if you want the measurement units to change like the inches, You can see it changed to the inches, centimeters. I am selecting the centimeters. Likewise, if you want to change the view of the page, you can use this view option. So likewise, you can see it. And coming to the save, if you want to save this, you can use the save option, or you can directly do Control S. Control S option to save it, to save to the PC or to save anything. You can use this save option. Likewise, you can do this. I am not saving it. Hope you guys know about the save. I am not saving this. Likewise, word is used and like this one not also you I have explained. Like this one not explained. Hope you guys learned about the one not. And this is the office. Hope you learned about this office. So this is the Excel. Hope you guys learn each and every option in the Excel sheet. So I am requesting you to learn of your own this PowerPoint and Word. Why? Because if you learn of your own only, you can know which and what is which option is used for what purpose. As I have explained each and every option this in this Excel sheet, you learn of your own. Same options are displayed here. So I will tell you one thing, home. Same options are displayed, as you can see, clipboard, slides. Just a slide is added here. Why? Because in Excel you use the cells, and in this PowerPoint you use the slides. And the one option, one extra option is added. This slideshow. I will explain you about this. So, if you have texted like this, my name is Akash, and if you have subtitle, I have a YouTube channel. YouTube channel. So like this, if you want to insert or if you want to add in a new slide, you can use this new slide option. A new slide displays here. My channel name is Learn More. You can give brief description about this. Likewise, in this channel, I'm going to explain you Microsoft related things. Microsoft related things. Like this, you can give brief description. So coming to the slideshow, I'm going to tell about this. If you want to change the design of this logo, as it is a white color, if you want to change it, the design like this, you can change the design. There are different type of designs which you can see here. So I'm giving you the slideshow. So this is the slideshow option. So slideshow is nothing but the full page of your desktop or laptop can be seen here like this. If you click the enter, it moves to the other page, or you can use the space bar too, or you can use your mouse pointer too to select it. So likewise, you can see this slideshow option in my YouTube account or in my channel. I have already explained about this PowerPoint very clearly. I will give the link in the description. You can go there and learn about this. And in the Word, I also explain the Word too. In my channel, you can go to the Word channel, or I will provide you the link about this Word. You can go there and you can learn from that. So this is about the MS Office. So hope you guys learned about this. If you have learned about this, or if you liked my video, and do like it and do share it and do subscribe to my channel. So if you don't like it, please do describe and mention why do you have disliked it. So maybe I think there is a conversation problem. So I thought to do only in Telugu my channel. So as per the request of the viewers, so I'm doing this in English. So if you have any conversation problem, or if you don't understand my conversation, so as I had given you the tip too, so you go to the option. So like you don't know about this option, so go to the art option. A dialog box appears, read about that. If you don't understand my conversation, so one can connect to my conversation, one cannot connect to my conversation. So Yeah, better if you don't understand my language or if you don't connect to my language. So better you go here. So likewise, you go here, a dialog box appears and you learn from that. So this is the big tip which I'm going to learn. So if you have understood what I have explained to, go to that option and read each and every option so that you can learn easily. So this is about the Microsoft applications or MS Office full course. So if you are having any doubts, you can mail me or you can comment in this. So my mail I am showing you. So I'm showing you my mail. Wait a little bit, once a moment. So my mail is akash.didla@gmail.com. So this is my mail. You can mail me and I will explain you everything. So or you can comment it. I'm going to give you the reply for the question which you had raised. So this is about the MS Office complete course. Hope you guys learn each and every option in this. So practice well, do well. After practicing only you can learn it. So practice makes man perfect. After practicing only you can learn each and every option. So this is about the course of the MS Office. So that's it for this tutorial. So if you're having any doubts, don't hesitate to comment or don't hesitate to mail me. I am going to explain you each and every question which you had raised, or I am surely giving to the each and every comment so which you had given me. So don't forget to like, or if you don't like it, don't forget to dislike, and tell me the reason why you had disliked it so I can know that and I can correct myself, so that I am telling you to or you can comment me so I can know why you had disliked it, or I can correct myself so in the further videos I can do well. So this is about this MS Office full course. So hope you learned about this. So having any doubts, don't hesitate to mail me. This is my mail which you are seeing on the screen, akash.didla@gmail.com. Don't forget to mail me and don't forget to like and subscribe. That's it for this MS Office course. Thank you. Thank you so much.